Good morning, everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. My name is France Gelina, and I'm the MPP for Nickel Belt. I'm also the health critic for my party, the NDP. I'm really pleased to be here this morning to announce that I am reintroducing my private member's bill called A Time to Care. Very much like what you see up there. A Time to Care died on the order paper when the House was prorogued. But it is a bill worth reintroducing. The bill is quite simple. It will legislate a minimum standards of hands-on care in every long-term care homes in Ontario. The residents in Ontario long-term care homes need more hands-on nursing care and personal support services, and my bill will ensure that they get it. There are over 78,000 residents in our long-term care homes in Ontario, and the quality of their care is a priority for their families, for the long-term care staff, for the union that represents them, as well as for my party, the NDP. Everyone knows that many residents entering a long-term care home today, they are frailer and have more complex needs than ever before. Personal support workers, nurses, long-term care staff members do their very best every single day to provide good care, but they can't do it alone. The most recent report on long-term care by the Chief Coroners of Ontario recommends that the government address this urgent needs and increase the availability of staff at the bedside for all our long-term care residents. So it was supposed, the minimum standard of care was supposed to be in the Long-Term Care Act when we changed the act way back in 2006. The government then said, oh, we won't put it in the act, we will put it in regulation so that if it changes, it will be easier. We accepted this. It took years for the regulations for the Long-Term Care Act to come out, and there was no minimum standard of care. They told us that they were to ask Ms. Sharkey to do a report specifically on minimum standard of care. We waited for the Sharkey's report. Ms. Sharkey tabled her report, still no minimum standards of care. So I took the next best step and decided to introduce it as a private member's bill. We have waited long enough. Our loved ones in long-term care homes have waited long enough. The time for action is now. With me today, to my right, is Candace Rennick. Candace is the Secretary-Treasurer of QP Ontario and a former long-term care home worker. Candace.
Thank you very much, France. My name is Candace Rennick. Like France said, I'm the Secretary-Treasurer of QP Ontario, and prior to that spent over 15 years working on the front line in a long-term care facility, and now I'm the daughter of a parent in a long-term care facility. QP Ontario is the largest union in the province. We represent tens of thousands of frontline healthcare workers. And on behalf of those QP members, I want to thank MPP Gelina and the NDP for the steps being taken to make this issue a priority. And we're calling on all political parties to put partisan politics aside to support this piece of legislation. We also want to thank Ms. Gelina for acting so quickly to ensure that there is no further delay. Because the truth is, seniors in this province have been waiting long enough. While there is complete and total lack of political will to make meaningful changes to the law to support Ontario's seniors, it means seniors continue to wait for the care that they truly deserve and require. We've all heard the stories about seniors being forced to wait hours before taken to the toilet, residents and staff being placed in unsafe situations due to chronic understaffing, feeding and daily activities resembling more of an assembly line as opposed to the kind of respect and dignity that one deserves in their home. The days are long and often very, very lonely. Imagine, just imagine having to leave someone to die alone. Or imagine the thought of knowing that your loved one has died alone. Staff do the best they can with the resources that they have, but all too often those resources are not enough. There is little to no accountability to ensure that the dollars that are invested actually end up supporting the residents where it's needed the most, and that's at the bedside. This bill can change that. This bill is about ensuring that there will be rules and requirements that have to be met regarding care levels for each and every resident. This bill is about making sure that residents get the respect and the dignity that they deserve. It's about enhancing the quality of life for all people who live in Ontario's long-term care homes and saying that it's time that they come first. We're calling on the Liberal government to follow through with one of its many priorities and promises to enhance the quality of lives for seniors in this province. We're calling on all parties to put partisan politics aside and put their support behind this bill. Thousands of people have signed our petition. They've called on their MPPs to support a time to care standard. From every corner of the province, family members, seniors, and workers, we all know that the time to care, the time to act for the time to care, is now. Thank you.
Thank you, Candace. To her right is Mr. Tom Crothers. Tom is the chair of the Advocacy Committee of Family Councils. Tom.
Thank you. The majority of long-term care residents cannot speak for themselves, and they need advocates. Family councils, made up of their families and friends, are the voice for the voiceless. Our group, the Family Council Network for Advocacy Committee, was responsible for a petition tabled by numerous MPPs and signed by over 25,000 Ontarian citizens asking the government to live up to the promises they made in 2008 to improve the care to 78,000 long-term care residents. Our members, by the thousands, are going into long-term care facilities across Ontario every day to see their loved ones and friends. They have expressed to us their major concern is the too little amount of direct hands-on care that their loved ones and friends receive. Or as we like to say, too little actual touch time. The family councils in our region come together for a regional meeting 3 to 4 times a year, and they deliver the same message, the need for more touch time. We have participated over the last 3 years in a rocking chair campaign that has been to more than 60 communities in Ontario, holding media conferences and talking to residents on the need for more care time. In every instance, everyone that we talked with all agree that the improvements in care time is badly needed. Our advocacy group has partnered with a similar group in the Champlain-Lynn, and they too have identified the same priority of need for more touch time. And together we have started a new petition, a joint petition, hoping to reach all the family councils within Ontario and all the long-term care residences, asking for exactly the same thing as this bill, more touch time. The acuity level of new residents is becoming greater and greater every month. This makes it even more urgent to increase the numbers and of those directly responsible for the care of our loved ones. Everyone in Ontario is or will be impacted in some way by this horrendous lack of adequate care for the seniors who help build our country. It is time for all Ontarians to speak up and hold our government accountable. We believe that the government is playing a shell game with our tax dollars and the health system, particularly the funding of the care for our most vulnerable citizens. Thus, all of what we have heard across the province and seen in the facilities of our members are part of the need for the legislation being proposed in this private member's bill, a time to care, because it is truly a time to care. Therefore, we are pleased to support the efforts of friends in this bill as it dovetails with our desire and efforts to see that our loved ones get the care they so rightly deserve. So thank you very much for your efforts.
Thank you, Tom. Next to Tom is Mrs. Joanne Widell. Joanne works in a long-term care home in Eastern Ontario, and she would be more than happy to answer questions if you have any questions for any of us. The bill will be reintroduced this afternoon at about 3:15, and it mandates a minimum of 4 hours of hands-on care in every long-term care homes in Ontario. And any of us will be happy to answer questions. On peut répondre aux questions en français.
estimates on how many hours of care this would add in Ontario and how much it would cost?
We know that there, way before the Long-Term Care Act was changed, we had a minimum of 2.2 hours of legislated hands-on care in the Act. Since the Long-Term Care Act was changed in 2006, there are no minimum standard. The government used to keep track of how many hours of hands-on cares was provided, and I used to file Freedom of Access of Information to get those numbers on a quarterly basis. Right now, when I ask for that information, this information is no longer being tracked by the government and no longer available to us. The last time I was able to get the number of hands-on care, we were at about 3.2, 3.5. So it's for every single patient, that means almost half an hour more care would be available to them.
Is that the minimum, or is that an average?
That was an average that they used to share with me, but they haven't shared that. Maybe.
Well, I think it's important to recognize as well that that average was a bit of a misrepresentation of the numbers, because it didn't actually translate into real hands-on care for this for the residents. It included people who were off sick, on vacation, who weren't actually physically working. So that was paid hours that necessarily didn't translate into worked hours. Just if I could, on your question, we actually did a survey of a sampling of QP long-term care facilities based on the schedules and what people actually work in the classifications that we're looking at, and I can tell you the numbers were hovering around 2.2 into 2.4, so quite low when you actually look at the hands-on care in a facility.
I'm sorry, how long ago was that, the 2.2 or 2.4?
It was about 4 years ago that we did the sampling.
And how do you think you can get to 4 hours? Nursing staff, more PSWs, and how many jobs would it create?
I haven't done the math to see how many more people would be required. We looked at it through the lens of the patients themselves. So the residents in long-term care home, if you look at their level of acuity, and they have this assessment, it's a standard assessment that is used throughout Ontario for every resident of long-term care home, and you look at their needs for feeding, for transport. So you get them up, you feed them, you wash them, transfer into a wheelchair if they are wheelchair bound, bring them for their activities of daily living, everybody goes to the bathroom, needs to be fed, etc., etc. So if you look at it from the eyes of a person living in a long-term care home, on an average day, everybody would need about 4 hours of hands-on care to be able to be fed, go to the bathroom, be clean, and be cared for. As simple as that. So if you start to look at it in your mind as to how long does it take you to get out of bed and get dressed in the morning? How long does it take you to go to the bathroom and shower and get ready? How long does it take you to have your breakfast? And so on for lunch, maybe have a nap in the afternoon, back up. So this is where the 4 hours of hands-on care come from.
It should be noted too that the 4 hours comes from research that was done approximately 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. In the intervening 10 years, the acuity level, as we mentioned, of the people now residing in long-term care has gone up tremendously, which means already 4 hours is out of date, if you will. It's based on a time period when people going into long-term care, they needed to be there, but their ability to do some care for themselves was much higher, and it's much, much lower now. So the number should actually be bigger. 4 hours is just a step. And we have to also remember that this, when you live in long-term care, it's not an 8 hour a day job. You're living there 24/7. You need care 24/7. So it's not like 4 hours of care between 8 and 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It's a 24 hour period that our loved ones are there needing care, whether it's at midnight when they're wandering, or they're getting disorientated, or whether it's time to get up in the morning. So 4 hours is a really great first step.
To add to Tom's incident or issue is that a lot of the residents that we have now require they have a lot of special mental illnesses. There's a lot of Alzheimer's. There's a lot of people that need constant supervision. And there's no extra staff for that. That's all done by the PSWs and the RPN that are on that unit. And like the dementia units, that's a steady, have to interact all the time with the residents. And so that's very time consuming, let alone having to do the care for all those people and make sure that they're eating and they get something to drink and then they're changed on a regular basis. All those things take time and there is no extra staff for that.
Rocking chair campaign you mentioned?
Yes, this is a campaign that has gone on for three summers. It's done, it's organized by the Ontario Health Coalition's Long-Term Care Committee, which we're part of, our group. And what we do is in each year we visited about 20 to 23 communities right across the province, and we hold media conferences on street corners, and we get press out to almost every single community that we go to. We deliver exactly the same message because everyone that's involved in this issue has the same lens. We all know that we need more touch time. So we basically go right across the province. We set up this huge rocking chair. It's 10 feet high, solid wood, a lot of fun to set up. Take it down, put it in a car, go to the next community and do the same thing. We're bringing the focus of the local community and the community press to the needs that that community needs. And it's a lot of fun, but it's also a very, very important way of communicating the need.
So if I could just lastly, when France introduces the bill later on this afternoon, we're going to be going across the province in the weeks and in months to come, holding community forums and a series of media events around the province to promote the bill, to raise awareness of the ever-growing crisis in long-term care, and to build some broader community support for the acceptance of the bill. So watch for those activities.
Mm-hmm. I mean, long-term care is not sexy. It's not controversial. It never grabs headlines except for the wrong reason when something derails, but it is the right thing to do. You cannot walk into any long-term care home without having family members, friends who come and reach out and say, the staff is running ragged, they do a great job, there's just not enough hands-on care. And this is why the campaign for the Time to Care. I also wanted to introduce Mr. Jerry Wheely. He's a member of the Family Council in Nemo Long-Term Care Home and would be more than willing to share comments with the media if you wanted one-on-one. Thank you so much for coming. And remember, it's Time to Care.
Thanks, friends.
Thank you.